If you are interested in AI and the intersection between AI and no code, then you almost certainly already heard the amazing news from last week that Sofdr finally announced their new AI builder, meaning that we can now build applications inside of Sofdr coming entirely from artificial intelligence. What does this mean? Frankly, I haven't even looked at it yet myself, but I am excited to start exploring this feature. So if you want a front row seat as I go step by step through the AI builder in Sofdr, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, and it's our mission to help you to get organized and automated inside of no-code tools. Sofdr is one of our favorite no-code tools, and leveraging the power of AI alongside of Sofdr is really going to help it go to the next level. Now, before we get into the heart of this video, I first want to invite you to join me for some automation training. If you are new to no-code tools like this, the biggest thing that you can do to start leveraging these tools and increase your efficiency is to understand how to build no-code automation. I've got a free training that I put together for you. You can grab that training at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration, or check wherever you found this video, there will be links. But without further ado, let's go ahead and hop on into this screen here. We are gonna go into the new Sofdr AI application. If you are not familiar with Sofdr, this is my Sofdr dashboard, and each one of these little pieces here is its own application that I've built inside of Sofdr. Sofdr is my front-end portal tool of choice, which allows me to add a layer onto Airtable or Smart Suite, which is also coming soon, or Google Sheets. That way I can keep my data wherever I want, but I can have my users interacting with that data through the web application that I build in Sofdr. All right, so I need to go ahead and start building a new application here using the AI, but before I do that, I've got a lot of questions about what it's even capable of, so I'm gonna swing over to Sofdr's blog on the topic. I'll include links to this blog wherever you found this video as well. But this particular blog is the next leap in no-code app creation, introducing Sofdr's AI app generator. So what's the big deal here? Well, as Sofdr says, AI has predominantly been used for automating small-scale tasks like text and image generation. That's largely true. For the most part, that's how I use a lot of AI in our business. But some products will let you build simple static websites with AI. Also true, I've experimented with some of these, haven't really found any of them to be overwhelming or just that incredible, right? There's always so much work I feel like I have to do as the end user, but I can see how some people might enjoy leveraging AI to give them the first few steps, you know, the building blocks get done for you, and then you can kind of refine from there. But Sofdr is saying, we've taken a giant step forward by enabling businesses to build fully functional applications with nothing but a simple prompt. Sounds too good to be true. I can't wait to test. All right, now with the power of AI, your business can effortlessly convert manual workflows into web applications complete with back-end database and a front-end interface for data management and business logic. This is starting to make me think that, in fact, I can build the entire back-end and the front-end with this AI application. If that's true, this is incredibly powerful. All right, behind the magic, what do we have? The debut of the AI app generator. You can easily create applications like client portals, directories, etc. Your app, shaped by your prompt and built on Sofdr, would encompass, it's including AI-generated designs, themes, and copy, AI-generated data in spreadsheets, soon Airtable. So it sounds like right now that backend is going into Google Sheets, okay. Business logic and user-friendly design, and also user roles and CRUD actions, which stands for create, read, update, and delete. These are the standard permissions that we want to give anyone who has access to our application. We have to consider what kind of things they can create, read, update, and delete for every different user type, all the different data that we're sharing. What are they getting access to? Well, all of this sounds like it's possible within the AI tool. So they're saying, don't take our word for it. Try it yourself. Let's generate an app. I'm willing to give it a shot. So let's go ahead and just use the test functionality here. You'll notice that when I click over here, I am still not even logged in on this particular screen. So my guess is that this is just gonna kind of be a test here. So let's go ahead with an internal tool for time off requests as well as a company directory. Well, let's see if it can put that together. Now, I haven't done a whole lot in terms of planning this out, but my first portion here, you can see I've got a blurry vision of something back here. It's given it a name called Time Finder, and it's used my prompt here, an internal tool for time off requests as well as a company directory. Okay. And this is kind of cool. I can come in here and mess with my accent color, and it's showing me in the background here how that is impacting the overall web application. Now, of course, I'm not actually in an application yet, but I can get a feel for how the application will look. I really like this sage green color right here, so I'm going to go with that, and I'm going to say generate your app. Now, again, I'm using this for the first time. I haven't really tested it before, so this is a first experience. I'm really curious to know how much detail do I have to go into on this prompt in order to get it to work, and also how long is it going to take for this thing to actually go. Now, this whole time I've been talking, we can see it's actually moving through different steps. That didn't take all that long at all. There were no cuts made to that portion of the video, so that was real time. Let's see it in action. It says it's ready. I'm willing to give it a shot. Let's see what it looks like. This is actually really cool. Okay, hold on. Wow. This is, I'm a little blown away right now. I kind of expected there to be some bugs or something, but this, I feel like it stood this thing up real quick. And I mean, I haven't tested it yet to see if it has all the functionality I want, but it's looking and feeling pretty good, right? So at a high level, I've got a nice little header here. It says Time Finder. I mean, that is what I wanted the app to be named, so that's awesome. I've got a sign-in option. I can easily manage time off and connect with colleagues. Great. Effortlessly request time off and find contact details of your fellow colleagues. Okay, let's get started. So again, this is my app. I haven't actually customized it yet, but you'll see in the upper right corner, I have that option. But I kind of want to see, like, what am I able to do? One of my favorite things about Sofdr's templates is that I can access them with different roles, different user experiences based on my role inside of the application. And right here, the AI is so smart that it's already given me two different types of roles to log into as. I've got a manager permission level as well as an individual contributor level. I'm really blown away by this because I didn't even talk to the AI about the fact that I wanted different levels in here. So it looks like, at least at a high level, maybe there are some minimum different roles that the AI is programmed to contribute when it creates a new application. Well, let's take a look from a manager perspective. I want to explore that as a manager. And with just a simple click, I'm able to now access this. So I'm imagining now that I am this manager named Yukiko. Effortlessly require time off. Okay. I can scroll down here and look at the different folks inside of my application. So you could imagine that we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 different employees of sample data. We can drill into these employees. We get that nice sidebar. David, Johnson, email, sales, all of this information. If I want to edit this information, I can click it. Brings it up. Great. I can update this stuff. Let's say the phone number was wrong. Update that. I mean, this would have taken me at least an hour just to build the foundation, right? To come in and say, I want this particular page to be editable by managers only. Let's give that specific user group that type of permission. I mean, this is really powerful stuff. The fact that here we are with this built already. Now, I do have an issue with the phone number here. We noticed that it didn't quite save right. So I don't know what happened there. Let me go back here and just put another one in. Let me see. +1. And let's see if I can update that. It looked like there might have been an issue in my saving that phone number when I updated it prior. Now we have it. So everything seems to be fine. I don't know how in the world they got this thing working to the point where it's doing all of this so quickly, but this is really, really awesome, right? I mean, the fact that I can do this, I can add employees because I'm a manager, right? I'm assuming that not everyone would have this permission, but here I could add a new record. Let's just make one really quickly. I'll go with Jane Doe. We already have a John Doe in the system. And maybe I have to assign them to these different things, but I'll leave these blank. they don't appear to be required. I'm going to add that new user, and we should see that person here, immediately available. Jane is right here. I mean, this is pretty powerful stuff. Time off requests is going to be the big portion of this, right? So we've got our employee directory, but also time off requests. And of course, this is important if we're managing a team and people need to put in for time off and all of these things. If I look at my time off requests, I can see an employee has requested this with a specific start and end date. I wonder if I have some way of validating this. Yes, I have the status of approved here, so I can make this approved or... And of course, I also have the reason for this this request. So if I were to add a new time off request, I could do that just like this, very similar to adding a new employee. And of course, I have the plus time off request right here, which is almost the same submission as the previous one. But this is really cool stuff. Now, the part that I wish I had was a linked relationship here. And I think that this is because it's using Google Sheets as the background, or maybe we just haven't customize the app far enough yet, but I would hope to see like a drop down of employees that actually already exist in my system rather than having just a keyed in thing here. Now, also with status here, I'd like to see a drop down for something like different options for status as opposed to needing to fill in the blank, right? So text as opposed to a select field. But this is kind of getting in the minutiae of this. I mean, 99% of this is already built out for me. This is pretty awesome stuff. All right, so let's see how customizing the app works. When I click on customize the app up there, it's opening something else. This is the actual software backend, the actual application itself. And I can drop in here and I see all the different parts, the different blocks for these pages. I can look at all the different pages that were built. So it gave me an employees page, which we already explored. It gave me the form page, with the time off requests, one of these is a list and one of them is the details. So when I open them up and I look at the details, same thing with user profiles and all the sign-in pages. I mean, this is a lot. All of this created from a simple prompt. I mean, I gotta say, I'm really, really impressed, and I didn't even give it a very thoughtful prompt. I kind of just threw an idea out there and it put something in place for me. I'm sure there are things that I would want to customize about this and update it. But the fact that this entire application was built this quickly, it's stunning. I mean, it's just amazing to me how quickly it came together. And I'm really, really impressed by what software's put together here. So the only other thing I would wonder is, all about the data sources. Generally speaking, I come from building inside of Airtable. I would prefer to build in Airtable and not inside of something like Google Sheets. And here we see that we don't actually have any data sources using this application yet. Maybe we need to publish it first. Let's give that a try, see how that goes. If I were to publish it and go back to my settings, and let's go back to data sources. Yeah, I still don't have an actual data source stood up with this yet. I'm wondering if software has somehow created this database for me or the spreadsheet for me inside of Google Sheets. So I'm gonna actually drop into Google Drive here and see if I can't find if in fact it did create something new for me. Would it have been shared with me or it would be recent? Let's take a look. No, I only see videos here from our YouTube creation. So I'm not sure exactly where the back end of this schema is coming together, but pretty easily we could definitely stand something up here inside of our own systems. And the prompt did tell us that software was building the backend inside of Google Sheets. So it's very likely that there is something somewhere inside of my Google Sheets, and I just don't know where to find it because I rarely use Google Sheets. As I mentioned earlier, in a perfect world, I would much rather store this data in Airtable. So I will definitely be focused on building something there. And I hope that software will soon be able to make that update so that we have the Airtable backend. Hey, I know we went really quick in this video. There's obviously a lot to cover here because this is an incredibly powerful new feature, but I hope that you explore it yourself. And if there were any questions you had that I did not answer, be sure to drop them below wherever you found this video. That's it for this one. In the meantime, keep on building.